हेलो, गुड मॉर्निंग। डायट्री फैक्टर्स इन कैंसर, इट इज पॉसिबलेटेड दैट 80% ऑफ कैंसर्स मे बी ड्यू टू एनवायरमेंटल फैक्टर्स एंड इट इज पॉसिबल दैट सम डायटेटिक फैक्टर्स मे बी इन्वॉल्व। एक्सिस्टिंग नॉलेज इज रिव्यूड एज वन डायट्री फैक्ट। Population surveys have shown a strong positive correlation between cancer, colon, and dietary intake of fat. It has been suggested that the high fat intake accounts for a high incidence of colon cancer in Western communities. In Japan, recent increases in fat consumption have been associated with striking increase in rates of colon cancer. Dietary fat is believed to increase the rates of colon cancer. Dietary fat is increasing the secretion of bile acids in the bowel, which are then metabolized by bacterial flora into carcinogen or co-carcinogens. However, no known carcinogen has yet been identified from feces, and the evidence is thus incomplete. A positive correlation between per capita consumption of dietary fat and breast cancer rates has also been noted. A reduction in dietary fat may alter the risk of breast cancer, perhaps by increasing estrogen production or prolactin release. Next is dietary fiber. Several studies indicate that the risk of colon cancer is inversely related to the consumption of dietary fiber, which may protect against intestinal carcinogens or precursors by dilutional or other effects. Although the available epidemiological data are not entirely consistent, the weight of evidence generally supports the hypothesis that fiber protects against colon cancer. So in cancer, the dietary factors, mainly it is a fiber. One must take most increased fiber. What is increased fiber? Increased fiber is that is wheat, rice, vegetables, fruits, raw vegetables, etc. This actually, in our traditional system in Kerala, this dietary fiber, it's rice is the main thing. In North India, it is chapatis, it's wheat flour. It also contains fiber. Fiber means something should be there, undigested thing that should be evacuated daily, so that the harmful products won't remain in the body. So if the dietary fiber is reduced, that's the fast food and some drinks, some protein solution with ready-made digested proteins, etc. If they rely on apart from natural foods, then these things occur. That's the secretion, harmful secretions remain in the inside the body, and they produce cancer. So the ideal thing is possible. Those who can, they have time and they have knowledge, they make time to take a balanced diet with all the things, with fruits and vegetables. In our country, in Kerala, traditionally fruits and vegetables is very rare. Traditionally, people eat rice only, hundreds of years. But at that time, what happens is, 60 years ago, 70 years ago, there was no much businesses, education was not there. People used to do only some small business, like selling things, etc., making some things, products used by the people, etc., collecting forest goods. These things were done in the past, because there was no travel possible in before 60 years. There was no bus, no, only this water transport, that's canoes, and vehicles drawn by the ox cart, and sometimes horse carts. And very rich people. Only other than this regular timely transport, cheap transport was not available. So there were no big businesses or people traveling. But nowadays people have to travel long distances if possible, and such people usually take the balanced diet. Either they take the vitamins in a ready-made tablet form, which is cheap, but long term it does not is not effective much. So it's ideal to take some fruits and vegetables, locally available cheap fruits and vegetables. That's why some people can cultivate keera and drumstick leaves. These are available in the everywhere. They can plant it and use these things. And some fruits, papaya, etc. If you plant 5 or 6 trees, papaya trees all round, year round, there may be fruits. Such things can be done by everyone who is interested.